guys, it's really amazing to have you here once again. Okay, and in this particular project, we are going to be looking at C preprocessor. All right, we are going to be looking at this. Let me state here that this we are going to take this in solving this in looking at this project. We are going to first look at the quiz questions, after which we are going to dive right into explaining some of the concepts so that you have an idea about what we are doing. Then after that, we are going to go ahead to solve each and every one of the codes, all right, of the tax. We are going to solve the tax, all right. So I implore you, sit back there. Meanwhile, if you haven't subscribed, kindly subscribe to this channel. It's very important to encourage us, like, give us a thumbs up. We really need it to keep going, all right. So like I said, like I always say, please take your time to look through these resources. They are very important. Look through them. Okay, then again, these are the general requirements for this project. Alright. You could as well look at that too, but I believe it's general. Okay, so you could look at that. So let me expand this section, the quiz. Okay. Let me expand this. So for here, we have series of questions, I think about 13 of them also or more. So we are going to quickly look through them. So for question 0, the preprocessor generates assembly code. True or false? That will be false. Okay. Does it generate any assembly code? The macro, this file underscore file, expand to the name of the current input file in the form of a C string constant. This is a macro, and they said expand to the name of the current input file in the form of a string, C string constant. That's true. Okay. Form of a C string constant. So naturally, this will be a string. All right. This will be a string. So they say expand to the name of the current file. So macro, we are going to look at this concept shortly, all right. Then the preprocessor removes all comments. That will be true. Preprocessor removes comment. Okay. Then before we continue, let's explain some of these concepts so that it won't seem that we are just giving answers without talking about them. Okay. So let me maximize this. Okay, this is what we have here. Alright, preprocessor. So the preprocessor is always, the step in preprocessor is executed before the compilation of a source code. Alright, before any code is compiled, the system does preprocessing, all right, before compilation. That's the sequence. It does preprocessing before compilation, all right. So, and C processor have three general uses. One of them is directives, all right, constants, and macros. Okay, this is for directives, constants, and macros. So, what is directive? Directives are commands that tell the preprocessor to skip a part of a file. Believe you are getting that. Include another file or define a constant or macro. So that's what our preprocessors do. First, they give directives, and directives are command that tell the preprocessor to skip a part of a file, include another file, or define a constant or macro. So that's one of the major uses of a preprocessor. The second one will be for constants. Alright, and this is the general syntax. So for constants, let's quickly look at the concept. Okay, you can go through this material, it's always available. Look at the concept of constant. We said this is the general syntax for constants. okay, variety constant. So and in writing this constant, what does that constant do? You know, there are certain constants. It can be mathematical symbols, all right, such as pi. Okay, you have pi, and I think some others constants. There are other constants, all right. In writing constants, okay, you have to be very careful, because if you just write them such as this without including them in bracket, is the system is going to do, is going to mess up the operation we are trying to achieve. Okay, so it's better when you are writing constants, you include them in a bracket, all right. If not, it's going to perform another operation, and at the end of the day, you are not going to get what you want. So take for instance, if you have this, you have this, the system, we do the multiplication first before adding this pi, all right, but that's not what you want, so you have to include that in, you have to include that bracket whenever you are doing constants. We will go on to look at that later. So let's just still continue with solving, looking at our quizzes. Preprocessor removes all comment. Said that's true. Then, what is the GCC option that runs only the preprocessor? That would be this hyphen E. How do I come about that? If you look at what we have here. This GCC documentation, all right, if you read through, when you come across this hyphen E, it stops after the preprocessor stage, do not run the compiler process. So the output is in the form of a processor's code, which is sent to the standard output. So input files that does not require preprocessing are ignored. So this is it, all right. This is the documentation for this is the GCC documentation, so you can go through, you have a lot of concept to look at here, all right. So I believe that answers that, all right. So let's jump back. So what is the GCC option to run only the preprocessor? I said that, and we have looked at the GCC documentation. So what does the macro table size expand to? Okay, table size. Table size, what does it expand to? It will expand to 37. Look at it here. So table size expands to the value of table size here. What's the value? That's 37. So it's going to replace this table size with the value. All right, the preprocessor generates object code. That's false. It doesn't generate object code. So what will be the output of this program on a standard 64-bit Linux machine? Have the, you are including standard input, the header file, then you have defined this, okay, input and character, integer character, sorry, you have this function name main, all right, and integer, the type is integer and returning void. You are giving it, you know, you are initializing your int and giving it the value 5, all right, return size of I. So what does this, what is the output of this? Printf size of I, then your exclamation, and signed int size of I. Okay, this is going to return what? It's going to, size of I will be 1. Okay, more, we'll do more of that, give more example in the, when we are solving the task. So why should we use include guards in our header files? Include, why should we use include guards in our header files? Because we said so, or we should never ask why, to avoid the problem of double inclusion where they live with include directive. Okay, include guard that the concept. Let me show you. This is it. All right, so you could come back and look at this concept. Leave that to give you more insight about that. Okay, so this is it, to avoid the problem of double inclusion when dealing with include directive. This code we try to allocate 1024 bytes in the heap. Define buffer size, malloc buffer size, so it's going to include the value here. So that's true. This portion of code is actually using the standard library. That's false. The preprocessor links our code with libraries. No, it doesn't do that. That's false. So what is the step of compilation? In compiling, you go through these steps. Preprocessor comes before compilation. Alright, so it's preprocessor, compiler, assembler before you link. So does preprocessing, compilation, assembling before you link. 12, what will be the last 5 lines of the output of the command GCCE on this code? Standard library, you define this and return exit success. So what GCC on E? So this is it, guys. Like including a pointer to this void, okay, and returning 0. Okay, let's move on. This is the correct way to include the macro sub. Okay, these are arguments. This way, all right. First, these are your variables. Include them. Your arguments. Include them here. Then in bracket. So, and again, you have to take this one individually. So A minus bracket B. So that's the right way to do that. Null is a macro. That's true. Null is a macro. So I believe that will suffice, but for more explanation, kindly look through the resource materials. They will always be there available to you. Alright, so kindly look at those materials. So again, we have explained some of these concepts. Okay, then we have talked about directives, macros are function like declaration. So this is the syntax. You have define, then the macro name, and you include your argument. Okay, go to expander. You include your argument here after putting the name of the macro. Then you include your argument. So macros are function like declaration, but they work differently because you can expand them. You can use them for a lot of other stuff. Okay. And again, all preprocessor begins with, let me include that, you should know that all preprocessors begins with what? This hash symbol. All preprocessor begins with this, so please take note of that. All right. So let me restore this down so that I can go ahead. Then let me split my screen. All right. I believe. after that, so we can go ahead to start working on our tasks. I believe it's high time we do that. Okay, so let me, to be sure I'm in the root directory, I have to do cd root. And since I'm in the root directory, I have to do cd to move into this ls low level. Control C, I'll copy that. Control A, V, I'll paste. Alright, so I'm now in the ls. So for this directory, I have to create this directory. Alright, I have to create this. So alright, I'll light Control C, I'll copy that. Alright, if I paste it here, you already know this, the command to create directory, mkdir arrow. I paste it here. Okay, so it's saying that cannot create directory because it already exists. How do I know that? If you do ls, if you list files and directories, you're going to see this. So the directory has been created. So, but if you are doing it for the first time, you won't experience that error. It's going to create your directory successfully. So since I already have that, I'm going to cd to that directory. Alright, so I am inside that directory now. So you do this, you see that I am inside that directory. Alright, so let me just clear. What's the next thing we do? The next thing we're going to do is to create our readme file. Okay, it's to create our readme file. Looking at the requirement, that is evolve. The next thing is creating a readme file. Alright, if you have a readme file at the root of your folder. So we're going to use vi to do that. To do vi. readme.md. Alright, if I hit enter, you see, I believe you should have a non-empty readme, but I always say what I put here is simply the task questions here for the tasks. Alright, copy them individually and put them into the readme. Okay, for each of them. First one, object like macros. So to create a header file, copy this. So that's what you have here, just like that. For each of them, the task questions were copied, and I included them in the readme. So you can just copy that, do the same. Or if you don't want to do that, you could just include this title in the readme. Either way, ensure that you do not have an empty readme.md file. So once you are done with that, you can do your escape, then you do colon WQ. So I'm just going to quit since I'm not editing or saving anything. So after that you're going to press enter, you get out of there. So the next thing to do now . So since we now have our readme file, I'm gonna go ahead. Again, let's check our requirement. Always ensure you do this time and again so that you. Okay. Or you can go ahead and create your others kaputcha file. That file should not be pushed. So if you create that, it's okay. Go ahead and do that. Alright, to do that you underscore do vi underscore pucha .c, you hit enter, okay, to create that. So that file should not be pushed, so it's not compulsory to create that file since it should not be pushed to the remote. So that file. Okay, so that file is not there, so I'll just go ahead to, okay, let me check for the scope future file. Okay, we don't have that. Like I said, it's not compulsory to have that, but if you create it, that won't be bad. Okay, so right away we are going to jump into solving a task. Alright, since we have done the created the required files, right? By the way, the document, the source code, will be left in the description to this video. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and copy this file name, all right, by using Ctrl C, and I'll come here, I'll do VI Ctrl AV to paste that in, all right. So if I hit enter, this should be the content of this file. Okay, this should be the content of this file. This if and def, this stands for if not def, object like macros, then define object like macros, underscore h. So this if and def stands for if not def, alright, then you define size 1024 and end if. So put this content into this file. When you are done, you can now go ahead and do your escape, colon WQ. Just do Q since I'm not saving, I'll quit. So once you are done with that, you can of course go ahead to check with your Betty file name to be sure that your code is Betty compliant and follows the Betty documentation style. So if I hit enter, Betty is running, all right so you see Betty did not return any error, so that means Betty, we are correct, we obeyed everything, all Betty's requirements. So you can go ahead and do your git add. Alright, you hit enter, you do your git commit -m, your commit message, of course we use our file name here, you hit enter. Alright, then after that you can go ahead and do your git what, git push. Go ahead and do your git push. Once you hit enter, your code will be pushed to the remote repository. Then you can come back here and check your code. Alright, so running this check. Alright, so you see, check done, all tasks correct. So please, if you come across, if you miss out on any point, please go back, replay this video. It's gonna get everything and you're going to get the same result that we have here. Okay, so I'm going to close this right now, then we'll move to the next one, which is py. Creates a header file that defines a macro named py as an abbreviation for the token 3.14 .. So just come here and copy the file, Ctrl C, and I'll go ahead and do VI Ctrl AV, I'll paste that. So if I hit enter, this is it. If not def py underscore, define this, and they have another define py, the value of py, and if just this content should be in that file. Okay, remember they ask us to create a header file. So this is just an header file, nothing more, nothing less, just a header file. So this is what we have done. Alright, so once you are done with that, you can do your escape, colon WQ, alright, so save and quit. So tap enter, you again run your Betty file name, alright. No error was thrown, you can then do your git add, enter, you press enter, and you do your git commit. I've done this before, I don't need to push twice. So once you are done with that, you can then come down here to check your code. Alright, it's running, so the checks are correct. Alright, just follow through so that you can get same result. It's very important you do that. The next one is file name, right? A program that prints the name of the file it was compiled from, followed by a new line. You are not allowed to use the standard library. Write a program that prints the name of the file it was compiled from, followed by a new line. Okay, so here we simply created a header file for this one, but here we said we should write a program that prints the name. So first things first, we just go ahead and copy the file name. Okay, to do that I'll use Ctrl C, I'll come here, I'll do VI, paste that, Ctrl A, V. So this is it. Write a program that prints the name of the file it was compiled from, followed by a new line. So we are including standard input output header, then these are comment section. Alright, so this is our function declaration. So the name is main, we type integer and it's returning void. The argument or the parameter passed into the function is void. So printf percentage string, right, and underscore file, that prints the name of the file it was compiled from. So the end, you return zero is success. So that's what we did here. So that's just what is here basically. So once you are done with that, you are going to do your escape, then colon WQ. Just use Q because I'm not saving. So done with that, you're gonna go ahead to do your Betty file name. I'll paste in the file name, Betty file name. Hit enter. Betty is running. Alright, so it didn't return any error. If there was error, it would have been indicated. But it returned our main, that means you are correct. So you go ahead and do your git add dot, press enter. Okay, after that you do your git commit -m commit message, you hit enter, then you go ahead to do your git push. After git pushing, you hit enter, it's going to push your code to the remote GitHub repository. So once you are done with that, you can come here and run your checker is running, so it's all ticked correctly. All right so if you follow the guidelines, if you miss out, replay, follow the guidelines, and you're going to get that. All right not just getting it, ensure you look through the explanations we did on our part, then go through the resources, it's going to help you. So we move to the next one, function like macros. Like we said when we explained this concept earlier, that macros are function like declarations. All right function like that takes this name and pass in your arguments or your parameters into that. So that's what macros, function like declarations. So here they said write a function like macros ABS with the argument x that computes the absolute values of a number x. So first thing, I'll copy the file name to create the file using VI. I'm going to come here, do VI, paste that file name. If I hit enter, alright. So once again, write a function like macros. Alright, so this is it, more like a header. Alright, if end def, that is stand for if not def, function like macros, define function like macros _h, then define this, what this is the line that does that, the magic. ABS X, right, as the argument or parameter. So X, all right, they have include that in the separate. If it's less than zero, you can see why we included them in separate brackets, so that we will not have any problems when this function runs. If you include them separately, if you put them separately without individual putting them into individual brackets, is going to, at the end of the day, the program will not understand, the system will not understand what you are trying to do, and might give you a different result from what you expect or from what is expected. So that is why you must have to do that. Alright, so once you put in this end if and your program, then after doing that, you can now do your escape, then colon WQ, no save it, just go ahead and quit. You hit enter, you can check for with Betty find name, running Betty, so it didn't return any error. Alright, let me clear this part. There was no error, you can go ahead and do git add, hit enter, git commit. M, then you put in your commit message, you hit enter, then you can then do your git push, you can do your git push and hit enter. Once you are done, you can come back here and run your check your code. Alright, so it's running, so you see, check correctly, because it was the writing, did the writing there, so you can get the same result. Just follow through. So the last but not the least here will be sum. Write a function like macro sum with these two arguments that computes the sum of the number x and y. All right. So again, we come here to copy the file name for sum. Dot h, control c, I'll come back to my terminal, I'll do vi control av to paste that in. If I hit enter, so this is it. Function like macros, this is the line that's most precious to us. All right, so in this declaration you have sum with your argument x and y, then that does the sum. You see, you put them differently to avoid any issues, any problems. All right, to avoid giving you a result that you didn't expect. That's when we do that. That does the sum. So this we do at the end. You do end if. So once you are done with that, you can escape and do your colon WQ. All right. So once you are done, you hit enter. You escape that. Then you can do check for Betty. Your code is Betty compliant. Alright, Betty find name, I'll paste that. If I hit enter, Betty did not throw any error. I can now do git add dot, hit enter, git commit. And you hit enter, then after that you can now go ahead and do your git push. So you hit enter, I'm not pushing again, I've done that already. So after that you hit enter, they're going to push your code to the remote repository. Once you are done with that, you can come back here to check your code. You see, it's checked correctly, so that's correct. So once you get to this stage, congratulations, you will be able to accomplish all of this. Okay, so thank you so much. Please like and subscribe to this channel to keep us going. All right, if there's any question, drop them in the comment section of this video. And again, like I said, I'm going to leave the document to this code in the comment section. Please give us a thumbs up, like this video. Thank you so much. I'm going to see you in the next video. We'll see you in the next video. Thank you.